Hello again. Yeah, the 3 hours up, so they just terminated it on the computer. Okay, so no problem. We just continue. Case one and N is three. Okay, so 6, 9 minus 2, 7. Six and seven. Well, no. Yes. It is four. We have third diagonal, okay, and it's the second four inside of the diagonal. Okay, so how about this guy? And it's equal to four. Eight S ten. Let's see. Eight S ten. Yes, it is four in that triangle that we have, and N is five. Oh boy. Yeah, this should be four. Well, I don't have that many numbers in our Euclidean square there. But yeah, it has to be four. Okay, so because it's like 3, 4, 3, 4. Three, four. Three, four, three, four. Yeah, it will be. Okay, so. So. Here, what you have is on the left side, the increment is 2, like 6, 8, 10, right? 6, 8, 10. On the right side, increment is 3. Okay? 7, 10, 13. Okay? So we got that. How about the second number? It repeats 4, 3, 4, 3. Okay, we got to find formula for 3. Okay, and there'll be our next task. So that third diagonal, okay, and fourth diagonal, we appear as of 3. It goes like 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3. Okay. We will need to explore that. Okay, so we focus on third diagonal, like 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3. Okay, we have to find the second number. Okay, that's our next task at hand. Yeah, we get it. We get there, okay? Please be patient. Because after this, if we figure this all out, lower triangle, upper triangle, then we can find the Euclidean number function. Okay, you know, some algebraic expression. Man, that insect, I grabbed it. I had it in my hand, but it flew away. And let me try to get it again. Some kind of fruit fly, I think. Ah, I think it escaped on me again. Okay, well, whatever. When I see those insects, that's not very pretty. And that's also in my house, I want to kill it, okay? It's just a bug. Don't you want to kill mosquito when you see one? Oh, I do. This mosquito, blood sucker, you know. All right. So we are focusing on third diagonal, okay? And it goes like 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, okay? So let's just write it out. I think this magenta is doing just fine, okay? So the first occurrence of 3 is 5s6, okay? So 5s6. 3 is equal to 5s6 is equal to next occurrence 7s8. Next, 9s10. Let's compare this guy with 4. First occurrence, 4s5. Next, 6s7. Next, 8 and 9. Yeah, it's period of 2, right? So you add 2 here, 2 on the left side, 2 on the right side, 2 on the left side, 2 on the right side, because it's diagonal. Okay, so increment horizontally and vertically, they are both 2. Okay, that's the diagonal periodicity of 2. Okay, so yeah, that makes sense. And from here to there, all you gotta do is add 1. Okay. If you remember in our proof of vertical diagonal periodicity in the Euclidean triangular system coordinate, we had something like that, okay? We had third variable called L, because it can be 1 or 2 or 3 or whatever, right? Okay. Yeah, let's add 1 here. It become 4s5 become 5s6 because we are adding 1, right? What if you add 1 again? It becomes 6s7. It comes right back down, just goes like zigzag pattern. Okay, so there we are, next step. And later on, we kind of simplify that, right? I guess we'll do the same thing here, okay? So okay, so there we are, next step. And we take a break and we continue, okay? So well, we don't have to write it down, but let me look back how we proved that, how we went about that, and how we simplified it. Yeah, we used to call it diagonal periodicity theorem number two. I'm wondering if that's even necessary. I don't know. Oh, well, somehow we proved it, but we'll just do it, okay? So diagonal periodicity theorem, there's number one and number two, okay? Number one without L, number two with L, okay? So looks like, I think it's important to distinguish that. I just noticed, okay? So. Because diagonal periodic theorem number two is more general, okay? Yeah, I think it is important to distinguish between the two. Alright. They are not the same. Diagonal periodicity theorem number two, that's more generic. Okay, and we proved that, right? So diagonal DPT, diagonal periodicity theorem number one, is just a corollary, special case of DPT number two. Okay, so all that. Just something I noticed. Okay, we take a break, okay, and we continue. If you're up to it. All right, take five. you know, these insects, bugs in my house, I don't enjoy killing them. Okay, what do? I put some toilet paper around them and just flush down the toilet. I don't crush it because I don't want to eat this yucky, you know. Okay, so we have one more thing to prove, and after that, we'll fold it up for today because I'm sleepy. All right, so I gotta get back to work, have some dinner and everything. Okay, so we'll find some board to erase. Yeah, I think this guy can erase. Okay, so yeah, you go back there. Okay, I will enjoy the view. My man cleavage. The formula we want to prove is just extended diagonal theorem, I guess. I don't want to break my neck, but it's a nice stretching. How about the other way? This is equal to some constant or function of n, but it still not involve l, so l is like a period. Okay, so okay, just like n minus 1. Okay, yeah, we can call it lm, but yeah, this l can be any number, but we only need to consider l from 0 to n minus 2. Okay, so because the period is n minus 1, right? So l ranges from 0 to n minus 2. Okay, so there are n minus 1 of them. Alright, so yeah, we can say, but we don't have to because we know l goes over n minus 1 is still preserve the equality. Okay, so but for the sake of proof, for simplicity sake, we just do L between this. Okay? Alright, let's prove this. Okay? I'm tired. I'm sleepy. Cooking my dinner, by the way. Alright. We just proved like before, okay? So proof. We may not even finish this today, okay? So left hand side. Semicolon, how about that? By what transformation theorem. Kitty. Add them and subtract one. Oh my goodness. It is real quick. Sorry about that. Sorry. Just catch up, okay? So. I'm gonna put that board right in front of me because I don't wanna keep turning my neck like that. It's too inconvenient. Tidying things up for my dinner time. But I have my vodka, so dinner can wait. Oh, today's hot. Oh, really? So I can have a board right there, so I can just peep at it. Now we use periodic theorem, okay? To get rid of. Yeah, both of these guys. It's twice, right? Yeah. Multiply by 2, then subtract. They disappear. 4n minus 2. So it becomes 1 minus n as By reduction theorem, okay. I don't know if, yeah, probably LaTeX will allow this, okay, equal sign, and above that we have RT. Yeah, I think LaTeX is a very powerful Markov language, so I think it can allow that. There's ways to express this, okay. Yeah. Semi-computer programming language, quasi. Kind of word, I mean the text editor, LaTeX. That cool. I'm sorry, this is supposed to be E. Euclidean. Step counting function, okay. So. Now. So tedious, dude. Repetitious. Monkey business. Yeah, I'm Asian, right? So many of you call me a monkey. Actually, when I was growing up in South Korea in elementary school, we'll take a break from mathematics for a while. When I was in elementary school in South Korea, my nickname was Monkey. Why? Because I was very good at climbing the trees, just like monkeys. Okay, so. Even Korean Asians, they called me a monkey, okay? So if Americans, some other races, they call me monkey, I wouldn't get offended, okay? So. I I don't know too much about Chinese Kung Fu monkey style. I know a little bit. Okay, I know it's something very humorous. Okay, to disarm your enemy and also very versatile, agile. Yeah, monkey style is fantastic Kung Fu, by the way. Okay. So. Okay, by RPT. Because this is a negative number, we're just adding them, okay? So, add them together to make it positive, alright? So, 1, 1, okay, so, N. And then we have dot. Okay, they are mathematical sentences. Okay. Whew. Observe that we subtract these two guys to get rid of this ugly fox. Okay, so. Observe right foot of this roll. Beautiful roll. Right foot minus left foot. More than zero. Because n is more than 2. Okay? N minus 1 is more than 1. Of course it's more than 0, right? Yeah, it's same as what we proved up down there, okay? It's just same. But it will help us, okay? Because this may lead to Euclidean number function, okay, in this Euclidean triangle. Because this will lead to at least partial formulation in a closed form in the Euclidean square. And Euclidean square can be easily converted to Euclidean triangle. By sliding up, right? Diagonally, okay, so. Okay, period, because we have a mathematical sentence, okay. Therefore, left-hand side will go up there, right, so. This is smaller guy, okay, so this, by row reduction theorem. Okay, I'm making sure you can see it. Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm not staring at you, I'm trying to make sure you can see this, because it's beautiful and ugly, but dramatic, okay, so. All right. So this guy is smaller guy, you know, inequality, right? This whole thing, ugly thing, okay, oh boy. This whole freaking thing, okay, it boils down to this guy, which itself is ugly, okay, but we are making progress, okay. This whole right foot boils down to this small guy. Which is this, okay, so. But at least we are making progress, okay, so. sorry. We use reduction theorem, so we have to have plus 1. I always forget that. And with periodic theorem, periodicity theorem, I'm sorry. We want to subtract this guy, two guys, okay? So subtract it to get rid of the m minus 1 k plus l, okay? So then subtract it. M minus 1. And the rest. And by reduction theorem, Euclidean reduction theorem, we have to go through these motions, okay? So if you are watching through this, you're a saint, okay? I wouldn't watch this kind of boring lecture by somebody else. No, I would never do such a thing. You're a saint. Okay, so. I'm no saint, okay, so. And this is equal to rho reduction theorem, all right? Okay, you have m minus 1, k, l, they are both non-negative integers, and you have n minus 1 is less than this whole thing, because k, l, they are non-negative integers, okay, so. And n is more than 2, okay? So this guy is smaller, and n minus 1 is also more than 0. So this is the remainder, okay? So this is... Okay. And we'll do reduction theorem again. You know, just like Bible says, our effort will not be in vain. We'll be rewarded. We get paid. Maybe not by money, but by something else. Maybe by fame, power. Yeah. Honor. Prestige. Fame. We get paid. At least we are having fun here, okay? Some rewarding experience, pleasure, okay? To me, that's good enough. I don't need power and fame. I don't need anything. I'm having fun. I'm having enough fun, so. We'll do reduction theorem again, so, okay? So, n minus 1. Just like when I made this movie back in the days. I was satisfied by the fact that I made this movie all by myself, and I liked the final product. Okay, that was good enough for me. Okay? I liked the final product, the movie I made. Okay? observe. We're gonna do plus one, minus one, okay? So, and then factor it. N minus one and plus one somewhere, okay? So, it will become like N minus one, K plus one, okay? So minus one, then plus one, plus L plus one. Rho n minus 1. We are off by one, okay, because we have that L plus one, it could be equal to N minus one, so that's an issue. All right, so because we want it to be strictly less than n minus 1, okay? So that's an issue. Ay, ay, ay. I want to see that Euclidean square again. Okay. Man. Because we can prove a special case, you know, when L is equal to N minus 2, okay, but for the special case, we can always prove special cases, right? But for the generic, if you want to prove more general formula, okay, we may have to narrow down the set. It's easier to prove subset, okay? So we're gonna have to do that here, okay? That's fine, divide and conquer, okay? We prove subset, another subset, divide into two sets. That's fine, that's legit, okay? So we may have to modify this condition. Okay. We'll have to modify this into 3. Okay, then a plus 1 is less than n minus 2, which is less than n minus 1. Okay, the things that we left out, omitted, we're gonna prove that later. Okay, so. And which itself is accomplishment. Okay, we divide and conquer. Okay, we don't want to be too ambitious. All right, so we can do like bit by bit, little by little. Okay, because this is a very difficult problem. Okay, that's why it's brand new. Nobody has ever done this before, as far as I know. Okay, so okay. So yeah, L plus 1 is the remainder, right? Because we restricted our set to prove, alright? So, okay. And then we are back on track, alright? Yeah, the special borderline cases, we'll prove them separately, okay? And this becomes what? Now, test. This board is blocking my view, so remove it. Let's continue, alright? Let me drink a little, alright? So, you gotta at least give me that. Left hand side is equal to. Because of this, all right, L plus 1. I think we can relax this constraint a little bit, okay? I think it does depend on L, actually, okay? But at least we got rid of K, alright? What is L? L is a variable that's within this one cycle of this diagonal. Okay, you have what? Diagonal periodicity like 4, 3, 4, 3, or 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, and something else. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna have to expand that Euclidean square back there. Okay, so at least we got it okay. Okay, so. Well, it's some equation that we proved. I mean, it didn't result in Euclidean number function, but still. Well, that's what let's finish the proof, okay? So this is what some function of N and L that does not involve any K. And which is, so this guy is, whole thing is left hand side, this whole thing is right hand side, and question mark is here, and this is right hand side, so it's proven. Dot QED. Okay, and we need to name this, right? How about extended Euclidean square diagonal theorem? Well, we don't have to use the word extended. So Euclidean square lower diagonal theorem, okay? So, because we proved it, all right? So let me write this down, and then I'm gonna have dinner, okay? Because I'm hungry, I'm sleepy, and I gotta go back to work tomorrow, so okay. We proved it, okay? So yeah, we narrowed down the set. And we also put some more variable there, but still we got it okay. Okay, so let me look at the other diagonal theorem. Okay. Yeah, whatever. This is C and L, okay? It's function of L, N and L. Yeah, okay, so let me prove this. So. Yeah. Let me write it down. I'm going to take a picture of this too. Let me drink a little. How about this? I'm enjoying this. I hope you do too, okay? Yeah, mathematics, what a good hobby. Very healthy hobby too. We are using new technology of this laptop being a camera and uploading this into internet. This modern technology, right? But we are doing what? Pencil and paper, whiteboard, eraser. So good and new. I mean, old and new. Okay. Old and new. Good combination. Yeah, sometimes we do something very creative, but right now, just monkey business, very mechanical, just copying it down. Something creative, something mechanical, again, good balance. Because we want to give a break to our creative side of the brain, right? So that we live very long and we don't get any brain cancer. Okay, so. Too long. I'm sorry to be boring, okay, but it is what it is. Sometimes proofs can be very long, okay. I didn't intend this to be long like this, but it is what it is. Just to write this down, it takes forever. Oh. And it takes multiple sips of vodka. By the way, I'm running this dehumidifier. I run it like all day long, except when I sleep, because it's kind of noisy. Electrical dehumidifier, that really works well. Because this house without that electrical dehumidifier used to have a lot of fungus. There would be this fungal development on the wall and kitchen counter and everywhere, and the furniture and everywhere. So I try to use chemical dehumidifier, you know, desiccator, that did not work. So I purchased electrical dehumidifier, and since then there is no more fungus. And electricity wise, it doesn't take too much electricity, dehumidifier, okay? So I regularly empty that dehumidifier water collector like what, at least once a day. Because it's Alaska, okay? We have a lot of moisture, right? So, and it's been working very well. No more fungus. Okay? I also ventilate my house on a regular basis. I'm writing down the last line, okay, and then we'll wrap it up for the day. I'll eat, watch some TV shows, or some movie. Fall asleep, call it a day, and get back to work tomorrow, okay? So, alright. Now it's time for me to take a picture and then find my cell phone and okay, so thank you for everything. Thank you for being patient. Okay. Let me grab my cell phone before I forget, okay? Oh boy, it's been a long journey, really. Okay, let's take a nice picture of this. Good. And the other guy, very pretty. Blue color. Oh, I like that blue. Very, very pretty. All right, thank you. Thank you for everything. Thank you for being there for me. Good night, have a nice week. Bye, I hope you enjoy your weekend. Bye.